The Way of Kings by Brandon Sanderson. Oh my. So this book is not only something that has caught me by surprise, but has also just completely changed my opinion on Brandon Sanderson. I'm not going to harp on my past opinions. If you want to check those out, it was kind of lumped in with my Mistborn video, which I can put a card up somewhere around here. But as a quick overview, I thought Brandon Sanderson was a very good writer. I thought his plot was super strong in Mistborn, but I never really connected with the characters and was not an overall fan of where the direction of that story went, so that was just personal taste. But I just found his writing to be kind of elementary and a lot of dialogue that was repetitive. So that was kind of my big gripes with Sanderson. But there was a lot of good as well in Mistborn. Obviously, Brandon Sanderson is probably the best architect when it comes to a magic system, and his world building is quite good. So Way of Kings took all of the things that I found to be negatives in Mistborn and corrected them, in my opinion. There are a lot of people who put Sanderson as a future Tolkien or maybe a George R.R. Martin level writer in the fantasy genre, and I now get it. I actually do. I think this is like the beginning of a masterpiece. You know, in that Mistborn video, I actually got a lot of comments for both, saying that, no, Sanderson really is everything he's hyped up to be. And then some who agreed with me and said, I read Mistborn 2 as my first, and I'm not impressed. To all of those people who did agree with me with my Mistborn review, I gotta tell you, I really think you need to give this book a shot. It is a thick, thick book, okay? It's about 1,000 pages, and the ones after this are even longer. But I'm telling you, I think in the long form is where Sanderson shines, and I think that he has grown exponentially as a writer. So don't give up yet, because like of all things that get a lot of hype and are very popular, I mean, that's why there's such polarizing opinions, right? Because let's be honest, Sanderson sells. And there's a reason. There's a reason. But with anything, you want to buy into the hype. You want to get on the train, and I think this is the entry point. So you might now be wondering, well, what about The Way of Kings swayed you so much? And it's like I said, some of the things I felt like he lacked in Mistborn, I felt like he really picked up here. And I was very apprehensive when people told me that The Way of Kings was going to have characters that were great, because I thought his characters were very average, to be honest, in Mistborn. Whereas The Way of Kings, I feel like every single character is B+ to A- tier, except for one I found to maybe be B, but at his best, probably an A, like maybe a C+ B-, and then at his very best, like B+ A- territory, that's Kaladin. There are a full array of characters in this book, and they all feel important in their own right, and they all have such unique personalities, and I think it can somehow connect with some, like, you can find something for everyone in The Way of Kings character cast. Personally for me, Dalinar, which I guess most people really think, like, Kaladin's the man. For me, I thought that Shallan and Dalinar were just excellent. I could not wait to get to those chapters. It's not so much that Kaladin wasn't an amazing character, but I found Bridge 4 and that whole dynamic and those side characters to actually be a little bit more intriguing than Kaladin himself. But by the end of the book, I have to admit, I was a Kaladin fan, and we're talking like epic levels of like Randall Thor Wheel of Time stuff here. So if you are at all into that, or if you're into the Chosen One trope, I think this is something that you could really get behind. And you know what? There was actually one other character, and I guess he has I don't want to give anything away, but I guess he has a lot more ties than just to Stormlight Archive, and that is Wit. Wit has a small but very, very intriguing role here and kind of ties into what I love about Stormlight Archive's plot. It's like this book, it gives you just enough to where you kind of know what's going on. You get your feet settled into this amazing world that he's building. But there's a lot of mystique. There's a lot of things that kind of just go by the wayside and you go, oh, I hope we get back to that because I'm not really sure what they're talking about. Say one thing for Brandon Sanderson. Say he knows how to write a magic system and he knows how to write a plot that will hook you immediately. The magic system, I don't think it's totally fleshed out here in book one. I think it's something that we're going to get to later in the series. It seems like he's kind of slow rolling that a little bit, which I like. He's not overloading. I'm reading Warbreaker right now and I kind of feel like it's, even just the world building, it's kind of thrown in my face. I think, again, Sanderson in the long form really shines, and he's taking his time unveiling little pieces of the magic system. I think Mistborn had a better magic system so far, But it's still good. It's still great. You know, still one of the best you're going to find. Really, I'm not a huge critic when it comes to magic systems. I'm cool with soft. I'm cool with not having everything explained. But I do appreciate when someone puts a lot of time into making it unique and intrinsic. I think there's a lot of value in that. And I give credit where credit's due. And Sanderson's the best to do it. But the thing that got me is, so I was reading this while I was moving. As you notice, I hadn't posted in a while. And it wasn't that I wasn't reading, but I was moving. And this is my first video here in the new place. Hope you like it. Got my Game of Thrones collections and my germ shelf back here. But anyways, there was times where I was only getting to read a chapter a night because of the move. And this is one of those books, and A Song of Ice and Fire did this for me. It's one of those books you can read one chapter and really chew on it for a bit. Like, this is a book you'll reread more than likely. But it was cool being able to read like one to two chapters a night and really feel fulfilled. This is not a book that I wanted to read fast. This is a book I wanted to sit down and enjoy because there's a lot here. There's a lot of lore and there's a lot of world building. And while the setting could be it's a little mundane, you're out there on the Shattered Plain, so it's kind of a barren, but we do see other parts of the world, but that's kind of the mainstay. The lore and the culture that he's building, Wheel of Time-esque in its scale, but for me, way more intriguing and way more interesting. It's like little things in the world, and this is literally my favorite part of the entire book, is Sprens. So again, this is no spoilers, but Sprens are basically like little fairy particle organisms, maybe? But think like a fairy that appears or does its thing when a certain action or emotion is being felt. So instead of like gangrene in a wound, if you get stabbed, you will get rot spren. So it's like the emotion or the function spren is like the appendage on the end of the word. And I just thought it was such like a little thing that I think is gonna play a huge role later in the series. I don't know, I haven't read it yet. Don't tell me in the comments. I would rather figure it out by myself. But let me tell you what, I just thought they were so cool and just a little piece of pizzazz, if you will, that you can throw into this world. It added a lot to the scenes and it made it feel unique, but it's also very encapsulating and you wanna know more about it and more about the world. Specifically, I went to school for physics and I absolutely think quantum mechanics are probably the most intriguing and fantastical part of our world, right? And our real world and our science, with something that is cutting edge and it's something that we don't entirely understand yet. There's a chapter, one of the interludes, where I think it's an Ardent, is looking over the Spren. He's studying Sprens and how they react whenever they're observed, and he's noticing that when you observe the Spren, they behave differently than when you're not observing them, which sounds a lot like particles. And when you observe them, they don't act like particles, but they act like waves. So it's like a little bit of quantum mechanics. He took like the most interesting and unknown part of the physical world that we live in, and he kind of threw it in with these Sprens in his world. And, you know, for a physics guy, I don't know. I just thought that was such a cool touch and a really interesting inspiration. And maybe that won't click with anybody else, but for me, that's when I was like, okay, I'm in love. I'm in love with this book. You know, and a lot of times I do have dedicated reading times and I try to not scroll on my phone as much and I try to whip out my book whenever that happens. But I found myself like thinking like during work days about the way Kings and the chapters I had read prior. And I was just sneaking in chapters when I could. That is the kind of story and the plot progression we see here. I think the pacing is really strong. I've actually heard some people think that it's kind of boring. But maybe it's just the fact that there was such a wide cast of characters that I felt connected with pretty much each and every one of them. But it never felt like the story was stalling at all. And I kind of touched on a little bit. I know Kaladin seems to be everyone's favorite. But for me, Kaladin felt like the most bland of the characters. Definitely a little self-righteous. And I just couldn't get behind. I think he had amazing moments. And I think the way he pushed the plot ahead was necessary and well done. It's just that until the very end, now I'm kind of a Kaladin guy. I'm kind of a Kaladin guy, but definitely my least favorite, which is just interesting because a lot of people claim to be that they'd be their favorite. I gotta give a shout out to Petrick, my boy on Goodreads. I've talked about him before, but he told me that The Way of Kings was one of the best fantasy novels ever. And yeah, I think he's correct. I would put it up there. This is also probably the first book that I've read since The Song of Ice Fire where I feel like there is enough material here for so many different podcasts, YouTube channels, and just a lot of theories. And you know, I still have book two and three to go, and we got four coming out soon. And I'm reading Warbreaker, because apparently it ties in. And then Edge Dancer, I guess I got to read. If that's one complaint. So I know people love the connected universe, like Cosmere and Marvel, all these things that interact. It's like the thing to do now. And I respect the ambition of it, but it is a little deflating that, like, I love this book so much. Like, honestly, it's possibly, like, one of my favorite books of all time. Like, I would put it up there with Storm of Swords. Ruined by John Gwen is obviously one that I've ranted about here on the channel. And then, you know, Two Towers. I would put this book in those ranks, like, all-time great. Especially in modern fantasy. I don't necessarily mind reading tie-in novels. I usually like to go back. I like to read the main series and then fill in the gaps, right? But apparently, from what I've read, and I've talked to people on Twitter, the community's been great, by the way, but it's like you have to read Warbreaker if you want the big, impactful moments in the second book to really stick with you. And now you might be able to have past appreciation if you read it after, but that just seems to be the way things are. I don't love that I miss out on some of those impactful moments, but I'm nitpicking at this point. And while I'm nitpicking, I'm also going to say it's something I hated in Wheel of Time, and I hate it here, is whenever there's created arbitrary swear words like, burn it. You know, burn it, Rand. And here they're using storm a lot. Like, you know, I'm so storming mad. Storm you, storm this. Takes me right out. It just takes me out. I understand that it's part of the world building and the lore, and it's supposed to be atmosphere. I don't like it. Just a personal nitpick. It's not something where I'm like, don't pick up this book. They say storm it, don't pick it up. Not what I'm saying. But it's something that I just absolutely despise. And I know this is coming off extremely ranty. It's because I have so many things I'm thinking about in this book. And I'm also trying not to spoil it for you, because this is one of those series. Obviously it's ongoing, and I never would want to ruin this experience for anyone, because I found this just to be such a great book. And maybe it's just the time I read it, moving and everything and being kind of stressed out, but this really captured me. It really captured me. And speaking of captured, once you're done reading it, Captured in Words, a YouTube channel, I might try to put the link down here if I remember, has a summary of the book that you should definitely check out after you read the book. It is probably one of the best fantasy videos I've ever seen on YouTube, and I actually missed like one or two things and got a little bit of Cosmere knowledge after the fact. So once you're done reading the book, specifically after you're done, go check out that video by Caption Awards. It's I think it's just called like Let's Summarize Awakenings. Like I said, I'll try to remember to put a link down below. But an amazing, ridiculously action-packed, lore-packed world here on Roshar. I think this edition, by the way, this is the trade paperback, is so cool. I'm trying to get more into like talking about covers, because I judge books by their covers, if I'm being honest. And this one is really, it's really strong. I really like it. But on top of that, I also just love the illustrations that come in this. Shallan is definitely one of my favorite characters. Might be my favorite. It's either her or Dalinar. Haven't decided. But our wit's up there too. See, it's hard. It's a good cast of characters. But Shallan likes to sketch, and as you flip through, you actually get to see the sketches that they talk about her drawing in the book. Not at specific times. Like, not they don't show it to you as they talk about it, but just like you open up a chapter and you see a sketch, and then you see her writing that sketch in later chapters or prior chapters. Nice touch. I think this was well worth it. I actually had the Mask of Mayhar kit paperback and ended up donating it and then buying the trade paperback because I'm an idiot. But man, I think the Mass Market paperback, way too big to hold. And the illustrated version is sick. For book four, I'm going to probably get on ebook and then wait the year and hope that they keep releasing these, because I really like to have a good set of books. And these qualify, because the cover's amazing. And before I go too long, I'm just going to wrap up. But I wanted to also just note that when it comes to being original, there are tropes in this book. Like the Chosen One trope's definitely there. I'm sure there's a few others, but I don't think about those tropes in these type of books. Whenever something is so plot driven and so well put together, it's very cohesive, and a lot of little original things sprinkled in, like Spren or the caste system being eye color. Those little cherries on top, man, that just round out this story and make it one that I think you would want to experience if you were a fantasy reader. No such thing as a must read. But I highly, highly recommend it. And I think Sanderson did a really good job of introducing this. And I kind of knew going in that this was a theme that he did, but mental illness is at the forefront of this story. in different ways. Some of it's in your face and some of it's not. I think it tackles it really well, and I'm excited to see where it goes, and I hope that he continues to pay it the respect that he did in book one. And I gotta get through Warbreaker so I can start book two. So if you are a Sanderson fan, you probably already read this, but if maybe you're working your way through the Cosmere, I gotta tell you, you are in for a treat when you get to this. And if you're a Sanderson denier like I used to be, and now I am converted to the Church of Sanderson, I guess, to Brando Sando, man, give this a shot, okay? I would implore you to really give The Way of Kings a chance, because I think this is the prime work coming from one of the best modern fantasy authors in our time, you know, maybe ever. So it's definitely worth it. Get lost in the world. Relax, you know. There's a lot of craziness going on in the world, and I know I was super stressed with moving and not being able to post videos, and I don't know, maybe it's just the right time, but this book felt as close to perfect as possible. May make some more Way of Kings videos on here. I might even do like a spoiler review. I haven't decided yet. I just have a big backlog. Even though I haven't been posting a video in about a month, I was definitely reading. I still have to review all of the First Law up into Heroes. I have to review Fever Dream by George R.R. Martin. I did Ender's Game by Orson Scott Card. And I also read the rest of Dagger and Coin, which I'm probably just going to do a video to recap that whole series. And I have some pretty interesting thoughts on that. This is absolutely a 5 out of 5 recommend to everybody, and I'll be putting out some more content for the Stormlight Archive as I get more and more into the Cosmere. And hey, if you liked the video, hit the thumbs up. If you didn't like it, hit the thumbs down. And if you want to see more of my Cosmere reviews and just fantasy stuff in general, I'm going to be reviewing all types of books. Man, this fall, we got some big hitters coming, right? Joe Abercrombie has one coming down the pipe, and I got to get those reviews out. So hit subscribe if you want to check those out. And I thank you so much for giving me some of your time. And I hope you enjoy The Way of Kings as much as I did. And if you do read it or you have, let me know down in the comments, and let's have a little discussion about it, because I'm fired up. I'm fired up about the Cosmere, and I'm fired up about The Way of Kings and the Stormlight Archive. And can't wait to see what's next. I really can't. So until the next time I see you, be good, be safe, and remember to always keep turning the page.